Where was I? I was working in America, in San Francisco. I was selling life insurance. And I met a guy from EMI, a guy called Fred Cantrell, who'd won a trip. He was a label manager for Motown. And we went on the piss for 2 weeks. Got absolutely hammered. And he said to me, if ever I'm back in England and I wanted a job, he was going to Island Records as the sales manager and said, if I came to see him, give him a job, give me a job. So it was about 18 months later, I came back to England. I went and called on this guy, Fred Cantrell. He remembered me and he gave me a job. And the job was, it was a Ford Cortina. It was all pre-releases from Jamaica. And I had to go to Brixton Market, terrified, and sell them the pre-releases from Jamaica. I had to go to Wolverhampton, I had to go to Derby. And my job was all cash, none of them had accounts. So it was Chris Blackwell's favorite records from Jamaica that he wanted to promote here. So I'd go to the hairdressers in Brixton Market where they sold pre-releases, and a guy would be there with his foot in the back of some woman's head trying to straighten it out, and then he'd go, "Yo, man!" And I'd have the records, and he'd give me the cash, and I'd give him the records. Then I'd go to Wolverhampton. There was a shop called Sir Christopher, and if I got there after the geezer with the ganja arrived, he said, "No, John, come by no record." If I got there before, he'd buy the records off me. But sometimes I used to go there and the door would be open and there was nobody there, but this guy would be asleep on the floor. He just had the ganja man had been there and he'd be fucking totally out of it. So my job was a West Indian sales van rep. So that's, and I did that for about 18 months. It was fantastic, just a wonderful experience. All the dub records, all the early Marley records, anything that was hot in Jamaica, Chris would want to bring on pre-release, test it out in the stores as to whether to release them. But then those that were popular, Chris would manufacture. My Boy Lollipop, those, you know, and it was fantastic. But it was, I didn't get robbed, thank God. Never. They stole some stuff off the van. But invariably they were in debt, but I had to beat the ganja man. If I got there before the ganja man got there, business was good. If not, I was fucked. But it was just fantastic. It was just brilliant days.